Hey guys, welcome to our channel. Maria here and William. Okay, today we're going to talk about commercial food. There's a lot of things we need to say about it, so if you're interested, please keep watching. Okay, one very important thing we need to talk about commercial food is why are we giving commercial food to rabbits? That's the first important thing we need to ask ourselves. So, why are we giving pellets to rabbits? Well, it's very important because hay is only a source of fiber and it's not a source of vitamins and minerals. So that is why we give pellets to your rabbits, to our rabbits. Another thing is, if you only wanted to give vegetables and hay, you needed to give 14 to 17 vegetables per day, so your rabbits would get all the nutrients and vitamins they needed. So that is why we also give pellets. Well, pellets were actually made to help us humans, not to help dogs or cats or rabbits, but to help humans, so it would be easier for us to give the nutrients and vitamins they need. Of course, in the wild, they're not going to get pellets, so they eat everything they can find. We start with grass, any vegetable they can find, fruits, seeds, anything. But here at home, since we don't have the time to find 14 to 15 vegetables for them to eat, that is why we give pellets, because it's so much easier and it's compressed to one little thing that helps them to gain all the nutrition they need. Okay, I wanted to give you an example. Is in the Guinness World Record is Doe. It's the rabbit that lived more years, was 17 years if I'm not mistaken. And Doe was fed only hay and pellets, and he lived until 17 years old. So that's something we need to think about. Alright, now we're going to talk about mixed foods and pellets. Mixed foods are normally made of sugar, seeds, cereal, and dry fruits. Pellets, we are talking about compressed minerals and vitamins in one little grain, alright? There are a lot of problems with mixed foods. The first one is that rabbits are selected animals, so they pick everything they want to eat. So, for example, we're talking about mixed foods, of course they're going to pick the dried fruits because it has sugar, so it's bad for them. And some rabbits don't eat the rest of it. So rabbits, they only eat what they want to. Okay, so another thing about mixed foods is they have less fiber, more protein, more fats, and more sugar. So that is why in the long term, they're going to get GI stasis, they're going to have kidney problems, they're going to have teeth problems, and so on. So it's very important to pick a pellet that is compressed and not mixed. Alright, so how are we going to choose a good pellet food? So the first thing is the quality of the grain, the date in the bag, the guaranteed analysis, and ingredients, of course. So the first thing is the quality of the grain. So the grain should be of a uniform color, green, of course. It should be hard. It shouldn't have yellow bits or blackish bits, and it shouldn't have dust, because dust can cause respiratory problems in the long run, alright? So the next thing is the date. Most minerals and vitamins only last 3 to 6 months. Okay, so if you buy a bigger bag, please keep it in a container away from sunlight, because sunlight can damage a lot of minerals. So it's much better to buy a smaller bag, in my opinion, especially for a rabbit that is a small is a small animal and it doesn't eat a lot of it, so it's much better. Alright, so next we have the guaranteed analysis. Guaranteed analysis is very important because it allows us in a percentage form to analyze all the nutrients that they put in a pellet food. Alright, so the first thing we're going to talk about is protein. Protein is the first one that is listed normally in the guaranteed analysis. So too much protein can cause a lot of cyclotroph production and a lot of ammonia in urine, which can cause toxicity and respiratory problems. A protein level should be 13 to 17% in a rabbit diet. Alright, now we're going to talk about fat. Alright, so fat is usually listed as a minimum fat, which means that it has more fat, but never less. So the fat content should be 1 to 5%. It can also be acceptable for rabbits with long fur, 8%. Alright, fiber. Fiber is listed both with minimum and maximum. So minimum should be 16 to 18 and 20% maximum. And in younger rabbits, it could be 20 to 25%. Now we're going to talk about minerals. So the first one is calcium. The calcium is listed also in minimum and maximum. The minimum should be 0.6% and maximum 1.1%. Phosphorus is usually referred as minimal, being 0.4% the acceptable. Salt could be minimum of 0.5% and maximum 1%. Vitamins. Vitamins are also listed in the guaranteed analysis, some of them at least. So the first one is vitamin A, and the vitamin A is usually 4,500 to 5,000. So the vitamin D shouldn't be supplemented above 2,000 of international unity. Now talking about ingredients, there's a first thing you need to know is that if the first ingredient comes first, it's the one that has more quantity in a pellet food, alright? So the first ingredient should always be timothy or alfalfa hay, alright? Or grass hay, okay? Never cereal, never fats, nothing like that. So that's something you need to keep in mind. Alright, the next ingredient could be a cereal, but nowadays you can actually find pellet foods without cereal also. How much food do you need to feed your rabbit per day? Well, it depends a lot. It depends on your rabbit, it depends on the age, the health, how much activity they have. A lot of things you need to count in how much you're going to give your rabbit. Normally it should be 1 cup per 1 kilogram of a rabbit. Okay, so 1 kilogram per, I think it's 2.4 pounds. Am I right? Let me see. Yes, exactly, 2.4 pounds of rabbit. So that's what you should give them. Normally I give in the morning, but there's a lot of people who give them in the morning and the night. They divide it in two, it's fine. It's very good to give food in the morning and in the afternoon, because rabbits also eat in the wild in the morning and the afternoon. But normally I give the veggies in the afternoon, so it makes the same thing, okay? Alright guys, that's it. It's just a little video just with small things that you need to know about how to choose a good food palette. But maybe in the long run I will make one more elaborated. We'll see. Well, thank you so much for watching guys, and please subscribe if you haven't already and hit that like button so I know you like it and you want to see more. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.